Hi, my name is Zoran Horvat. In this video, I will explain what covariant and contravariant types are and how do we use them when constructing generic types. Those terms originate from physics, I think, where we observe causes and effects. What happens if we change the scale of the cause? What happens to the consequence? If shrinking the cause causes the consequence to shrink as well, then those two are covariant. They are changing in the same direction. If scaling down the cause makes the effect scale up, become larger, then we are talking about contravariant cause and effect. In programming, that same thinking is applied to generic types, as you will see in just a minute. It all boils down to observing the Object Substitution Principle. That is the fundamental principle of object-oriented programming. And we can say that object-oriented programming is all about the substitution. So we have the base class and a derived class, the class that derives from it. And we can instantiate an object of the base class and assign it to a reference. So the point is that here we are assigning the base object to a base reference. That is legal, obviously, but it's also legal to assign a derived object to the base reference. Why is that important? It's important because compiler needs to verify members. So, for example, if we had a method on the base class, we want to call that member on the object X, which is, observe, the base object, and everything is all right. But we also want to invoke the same member on the Y object, which is the derived class, the object of the derived class, and compiler will observe the base reference which we have assigned and allow both invocations. Everything is all right in this piece of code. If I run the application, you will see that both objects know precisely which member to call. However, what if there were a member on the derived class as well? Could we invoke that member, the derived member, on the object Y, which is the object of the derived class? No, because compiler does not see that object as the derived object. It is accessing it through the reference to the base class. And base class has no reference which we are seeking, so this call is illegal. We must instantiate or at least assign the derived object to a reference of the derived type before accessing the derived member. Of course, we can also access the base member through the derived reference. That is legal as well. So these are the four possibilities we have when we have reference to the base type, reference to the derived type, and the members defined on both of them. This is how Object Substitution Principle works on regular types. However, and this is where we come to variance, what happens when we introduce generic types? Variance can be declared on interfaces and delegate types in C#. It is augmenting the Object Substitution Principle to work for generic types. So variance is all about object substitution when speaking about generic types, objects of generic types. And then when we come to generic interfaces or interfaces in general, they can either produce or consume objects. And that will be very important when speaking about variance. So the producing interface is producing an object of the parameter type T. And we denote that in C# with the keyword out. This out is indicating the covariant type, and you will see what covariant means when we start assigning references to these interfaces. On the other hand, if we had a consumer, an interface which consumes, which accepts the object of parameter type T through its member, then we would denote it as the in T, it is coming into the interface object, and we call that the contravariant type. What is the consequence of having this producer as covariant and this consumer as contravariant interfaces? For one thing, if we had a producer of base type, what can we do with that? This object is obviously returning instances of the base type. That is what its declaration says. But could we assign that to the derived reference? No, because this interface, the producer of base type, is returning something that is declared as the base type, and we cannot assign that to the derived. That would violate object substitution principle. So this assignment is not legal in C#. What is legal in C#, though, is if we start from the other end, from a producer of the derived type. We can obviously assign that, the product of that object, to the derived reference. Yes, that is the same thing. This interface is producing a derived object. It is declared so. But we can also assign that to the base reference. That is object substitution principle applied in a legal way. So, in a way, it turns out that the iProducer of the derived class behave like a derived interface from the iProducer of the base class. These interfaces, these two interfaces, are behaving covariantly. They are moving in the same direction. You derive a class, a generic parameter class, one from another, and the interfaces behave as if they were derived from one another in the same direction. But what happens if you start using the consumer, the consuming interface, the interface which is accepting objects? So the consumer of base can obviously receive an object, a concrete object of the base type. That is the same thing. So we can assign the new base to the method argument, which accepts a base. But what if we pass the derived object? Again, this is fine, because we can assign the derived object to the method argument declared as base. But what if we started from the other end? Consumer of the derived type. What then? Obviously, we can pass the derived object in, that is fine, but we cannot pass the base object in, because base cannot be assigned to the method argument accepting derived. That is how it is declared. So this invocation would violate the object substitution principle. In a way, consuming objects, consuming interfaces, generic interfaces, are behaving contravariantly, so that if you applied the derived class as the generic type parameter, then you would construct a base interface. It behaves oppositely. Let me show you. What would happen if you tried to assign these interface references one to another? Can we assign a producer of base type to the reference of the same type? Yes, of course, that is the same type. But can we assign a producer of derived class to the reference which is a producer of base? Yes, because the right-hand side would produce derived objects which are assignable to base objects. So this assignment is perfectly legal. What else? We can assign derived producer to the derived producer reference, of course, that is the same type. But we cannot do the other way around. The producer of base type is the super type of producer of derived, and this assignment is illegal when observing the object substitution principle and assignment rules in C#. But what happens to the consumer? If we had a reference to the consumer of derived, we can assign the consumer of base, because consumer of base is expecting the base object, and we can pass the derived object in. That's what makes it contravariant. This assignment is perfectly legal because consuming interfaces are behaving contravariantly. Of course, we can assign the consumer of base to the consumer of base reference, but we cannot assign the consumer of derived object to the consumer of base, because that means that somebody would try to pass the base object into a method expecting derived object, and that would fail. That assignment is not legal and that code would not compile. This is it. This is the entire picture showing you what can and what cannot be assigned given the two variant interfaces, one covariant with the out keyword, one contravariant with the in keyword. If you had an interface which is both receiving and returning objects of type T, then you cannot specify any variance on that interface. You cannot specify neither in nor out, because the only type that would satisfy both ends of the equation would be the type T itself. No base, no derived type of it would suffice. And so such interface is invariant. This is the whole story about interface variance. It is very simple indeed. Again, if you want to learn more, there is the whole course with a lot of demos, generics all the way through. If you want to learn generics, go there and watch that course. And that would be all in this video. Thank you for watching and see you soon.